Hello friends, kaise ho aap log? Welcome to a new video on the channel. And today I'm going to share with you a new accessory that I have bought for the Tiger 800. So as you know, I had just recently finished my ride to Rajasthan and I rode almost 2300 kilometers. Although I thoroughly enjoyed the roads that Rajasthan had to offer, there was one big issue: the windscreen on the 2017 Triumph Tiger. So this windscreen is pretty short, as you can see. When I sit in an upright position on the motorcycle and do long distances during the day, the wind blast directly hits me on my upper chest. So that's why I decided to order an aftermarket windscreen. The windscreen was scheduled to come in by 19th of December, when I was originally scheduled to start my ride, but it got delayed, it got stuck in customs. So here is the New Year present. Yo, this one seems pretty big and it promises to be 13 centimeter taller than the stock windscreen, and I'll show you the comparison after I uninstall the stock windshield. So here is the PUIG windscreen and here is the stock windscreen. The difference in height is 13 centimeters. That is what PUIG claims, and let's see how effective this one turns out to be after installation. So essentially there are 6-7 bolts that we need to remove with an Allen key that is provided along with the Triumph toolkit. So 6 bolts and it should be a pretty easy install. Let me give it a try.
A few moments later.
So finally the installation is complete. It was a little difficult than expected. It was the first time that I was installing an accessory on my own. Let me show you how the windshield looks like. So the quality of the windshield looks pretty good. It's pretty clear. So there are a couple of options that you get with the PUIG windscreen. There is a clear one, partially smoked, and then there is a proper black windscreen that you get. I was recommended to go with the clear one, so it does not pose any issues while riding in the dark. Let me just get on the bike and tell you how tall the windscreen looks relative to my riding posture. The addition in height is pretty significant. 13 centimeters really, I think, should do the trick here. And I'm sitting quite upright on the motorcycle right now. See, the top of the windshield is aligning almost with my chin, so I think all the air should be directed over and above my helmet. Anything that hits the helmet should be redirected quite well, because helmets, you know, are aerodynamically designed as well. So there is some good amount of adjusting that you can do to how the windshield is set up on your motorcycle. And that was something that was missing in the stock windshield as well. If you see, there are knobs provided on both the ends. This is one knob that can be easily unscrewed, loosened out. And you need to do the same thing from the other side as well. And now you can just simply move the windshield down or all the way up, depending on how you want it to be set up according to your height. So there are no prefixed hinges which allow you only 3 or 2 positions that you can settle into. You can basically put it in any position and tighten the screws. That's how it works. So there are a couple of things that you need to keep in mind when you're doing this installation if you plan to do it on your own. First, the complete setup of the stock windshield will come out. What I mean by that is, this is the original bracket that was, you know, attached to the stock windshield that comes from Triumph. So this bracket as a whole comes out. Why? Because the PUIG windshield comes with its own bracket. So that's why you don't want to unscrew the bolt which is attaching the windshield to the bracket, because the bracket as a whole will come out. The bolts that you need to unscrew are 1, second one is here, 3, 4, similarly 2 here again, one with the aux light and the other in the inside. Also, you need to take notice of these washers that come out while uninstalling the windscreen. The PUIG windscreen does not come with washers for the 2 bolts in the front, so you'll need to take the washers out of the stock one and put them in. The mistake that I made was I tried to unscrew this bolt, which was actually not required, because the whole assembly comes out, not just the windscreen. So enough of theory and let's do some practical testing. And I'll be taking the White Tiger on the highways and telling you how it feels like to ride. So I'll be trying out different settings. So right now I am trying the middle setting, if you can see.
this center one. It is not too low or not too high. So let's see how it works, and then I'll be changing the setting and letting you know. So here we are on open stretches of road, and immediately I am telling you there is a considerable amount of difference, and I'm not trying to justify my purchase here. This is something that is feeling like a big improvement right at the start. Riding at 60-70, I'm not getting any wind gusts, and normally I try to see where the airflow is with any sort of windshield, and I put my hand in front and see where the wind blast is. Till this height, there is no wind blast. After this one, there is the wind blast, which is almost above my eye level. And let's hit it out. That's good. Nothing is hitting my helmet. Earlier, as I told you, it was upper chest and the throat area, leave alone the protection to the head. Right now, all the wind that I'm feeling is, I would say, 80% on my arms. This is 110 112, huge improvement. And this was one thing that I was missing badly on my recent ride to Rajasthan. And now it feels like heaven. I think with this I could have even braved a lot of the cold weather quite easily. And you guys can also tell maybe by the wind noise that you hear in the helmet right now as I am speaking, and comparing it to the initial footage that I had shown to you. This is very good. 120 and still no issues. If you also own a 2017 model Triumph Tiger, I think this is a must-have addition. I was initially looking at, you know, extenders that are placed on top of the windscreen, but they tend to, you know, vibrate a little bit. That's why I wanted to have a taller windscreen in place, and then maybe after that think about putting an extender. But I think the windscreen on its own is providing great protection. What I tried till now was with the middle setting. If I go for the topmost setting, let me try that. So this is the topmost setting, and right now you can see it is almost 90 degrees, and this should provide even more wind protection. It looks a little odd. The wind blast would definitely reduce a little bit, but in the previous setting also it was, you know, a huge improvement. So I'm not sure why would someone opt for this setting unless you are 6'1", 6'2". I am 6, and the middle setting worked perfectly for me. This is the airflow channel right now. Earlier it was almost at my nose level. Right now it is at my forehead level. So some great versatility on offer. So that's it from my side, guys. I tried to cover most of the aspects about the installation and about the rationale for making this purchase. If you still have any questions, post them in the comment section below and I'll try to answer them. And obviously, if you like the video, like and subscribe to the channel. That really keeps me going. Till then, bye-bye and see you in the next one. Wow!